Hi, welcome to Free Academic English. I'm Geraldine, and today I'm gonna give you examples for how to make a self-study plan. A couple of weeks ago, SBS got a video where I taught you how to make a self-study plan. There. So today I'm gonna give you two examples for that. One example is short-term, like these days of quarantine, in which you're home and maybe you have more time and you wanna have a plan for studying English. And another example for long-term studies. Step one is to set a time. Think of how much time you have available and how much time you can use for studying English. For example, these days, maybe you have a lot of time. So you could say that you can study English up to 4 hours a day. But try to be realistic. If you can't handle 4 hours, then don't say you're gonna study 4 hours. But if you study 4 hours, divide those 4 hours. So considering that, you might think that this situation is gonna go for maybe 2 more weeks and you're gonna study 5 days a week. So you'll have 40 hours of study. Then you have to choose the material you're gonna use. Now, this is very personal and it depends on your specific needs, but it's a very important step. So you can take your time to find the right course for you or the right materials for you. Maybe you have a book at home, so that's great, that can be your material. Or maybe you want to find something online. There's lots of material there too, but it depends on what you want. Let's say, for example, that you want to improve your general English, and there are great platforms like Coursera or edX in which you can find short courses for this. For example, I found 3, one about improving your English for improving your career, English for improving your career, English grammar, or improving English communication skills. So you choose one, and when you enter to the course, if it's a course like that, they will tell you the amount of time required. Like they can say, this course lasts 20 hours total, or you should spend 4 hours a week on this, but since you're going to study more than that, so you can finish a week in a day, and so on. That way you know if you have enough or if you have too much of the time you set at the beginning. If it's a book, you can also look at the units. Usually also, and they also tell you how much time you're gonna spend per lesson. But let's say if there are short lessons, for example, if you want to study grammar, you can go to this webpage that is German. I don't know how to pronounce. English Hyphen, I suppose, I don't know. And it has all of the explanations about grammar in a short, concise way, almost like English grammar in use. So you can go there, for example, and see the units it has. For example, this page has 196 units about grammar, I think. So since you know you have 40 hours, you can choose 40 lessons, for example, or 80 lessons, because some of them are actually short. Or focus on tenses, if you know what you need, for instance. So again, this step is very important. Take your time for it. Step 3 is to make a schedule. Making a schedule is very important because it allows you to see what you did, what you're doing, and what you have to do. So it helps you stay focused. So it's important that you write it down or put it on your computer or wherever you want, but that you see there the days you're going to study, at the time you're going to study, and if it's possible, the lessons that you're going to study. But in general, really, you don't need that, but you know how much time it's going to take to finish the course you're taking. And step 4 would be to choose your extensive study material. Well, extensive study is like the things you're gonna do when you're not studying, but that are going to help you with your English. If you're just studying general English, for example, on your free time, when you're not studying, you can watch movies in English, or you can play games in English, or you can listen to podcasts, or listen to music, but paying attention maybe to the lyrics of the songs. And that way you continue learning without studying formally. That is a short-term example. If you need any help and you need many, and maybe you need a suggestion for what study material to use, don't hesitate to write it in the comments and I'll reply gladly. Stay home, stay safe, wash your hands, and I hope to see you soon.